Shortly after President Trump took office, Immigration and Customs Enforcement, known as ICE, began arresting hundreds of immigrants in very visible raids across the United States. But as internal ICE documents obtained first by the Washington Post show, half of those detained had either no criminal record or traffic convictions. Joining me now from Washington to discuss this is one of the reporters who broke the story, Maria Sacchetti. You have a set of data that is around Operation Crosscheck, which was one of the things that we all heard about. What did the data reveal, and how does that work with all of the larger roundups that have been happening?
Well, the data offered the first look at a breakdown of the immigration raid that occurred right after President Trump took office. And the way ICE classified it is traffic offenses, but we asked for more information, and they said that more than 90% of those offenses were drunk driving offenses.
I don't want to minimize that drunk driving is not a serious offense, but what about the criminals like the murderers and the rapists and so forth that the president said that was the focus, that's what we wanted to go after?
Exactly, and we know there are hundreds of those folks out there that who have been released, who were released under the Obama administration, and Trump very clearly made that a priority. He said he would what happened under the Obama administration would not happen under his administration, and we just haven't seen that.
So, what is the difference between what's been happening or what was on the books in terms of regulations or restrictions that the Obama administration had put on ICE enforcement and how they should prioritize who to round up and deport?
Well, the Obama administration, and we reported this, deported a lot of people who had never committed a crime, got a lot of criticism for doing that. And over time, the Obama administration issued memos that sought to curtail exactly the types of folks immigration officials could arrest and deport. And in 2014, late 2014, that really took effect. You can see the number of non-criminals and overall deportations going down the last couple of years of his administration.
Is there a chilling effect in terms of people that are coming forward, say, whistleblowers or witnesses to crimes or maybe even victims for fear that they will be deported in the process?
Well, at least two cities, Los Angeles and Houston, have reported that they're seeing fewer crimes, particularly sexual assaults and other crimes being reported by Latinos. So that's a big question. And the the Trump administration has said that victims or witnesses, you know, could be picked up. They say they're not their priority, that there are still protections in place for them. But if they're lawbreakers or if they've had an issue in the past, victims and witnesses could also be detained.
So there's kind of two steps to this. There's the detention part, then there's the deportation part. Is everybody who's getting detained getting deported? I mean, are the countries agreeing to take them back?
Right. So one really important detail here is the difference between the immigration system and the criminal system. In the criminal system, we know who gets arrested. You know, when someone's arrested, almost the next thing you see is their name and you get a little bit of background about them. The immigration system has not worked that way. We don't know who's getting arrested. We can't look at their files. We can't read the reports and the charges against them, even though they're civil charges. They're often held in the same types of jails as criminals. But there's very little public accountability in the immigration system.
All right, Maria Sacchetti of the Washington Post, thanks so much.
Thanks.